the craft of writing, and you are indeed a fine writer.
Thank you.
When did you start writing?
In the late 1990s. I've been writing for a long time. The late 1990s is when I kind of started to figure out what I wanted to say. And believe it or not, I didn't start as a praise and worship writer. So I really started writing a lot of urban stuff. And, you know, I was able to kind of articulate my heart, but it just wasn't translating as authentically as I wanted it to. And when I found the lane of praise and worship, like the rest of my history.
In him do I live out of my being. That's one line. You made an entire song.
Yeah, but the scriptures are chock full of ideas that can, you know, work for songs. And I think if we are intuitive enough to really listen to what God wants to say, God isn't always verbose. Sometimes he says things in a very, succinct manner. And sometimes we over-articulate what God is trying to say, and people miss the point. But there are times when God says, be still and know that I'm God.
And that's it. Here.
You don't need to be beyond that. You know what I mean? So as a songwriter, we have to be able to know when God says, that's enough. Just take that.
Well, that's awesome. And I tell you, when I hear that and I get in my meditative state, that is just enough. That's enough to really concentrate.
Absolutely.
Because sometimes when we're spending time with them, we have so much on our minds, we can be all over the place.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And so I was also thinking about you and the rhinestone line and that particular line of scripture and how so much has changed when it comes to what defines gospel music. Some people say that, is that your line of thinking?
I think the gospel should allude to the scriptures, but it doesn't necessarily have to be scripture based. And you don't have to necessarily quote a scripture in a lyric for the lyric to be gospel. It just needs to originate from God
and be about
Him.
Absolutely.
You can find it in the book, to me, it's gospel music. Even if you don't necessarily say Jesus or God in it, you can't necessarily exclude that from the gospel genre. And, but yes, some people are kind of prudes, for lack of a better term, as it relates to what they call gospel and what isn't gospel. And I think God speaks in so many different ways. There were a lot of times when Jesus spoke and he didn't mention his father, but everybody knew who he represented, where he was coming from. And I think the gospel music genre has to be open to that idea as well.
And where are you in your sweet spot as a writer? When do you have those aha moments when you know, this is the line, this is the song, this is really speaking my heart? Do you have those kinds of moments?
It varies, because there are times when the sweet spot is I'm on a plane and nobody's around me, so I can just write. The times I'm on a train, there are times I'm driving in my car and I have to pick up my phone and send an idea to the phone. So it really just depends on when God wants to release that song. And as a songwriter, we have to be open to whenever God decides to talk. We don't determine when he talks. He determines when he talks. We just have to be open enough to receive. So I can't say that there's a quote-unquote sweet spot for me. It's just that when he starts talking, I start missing.
Can you play this piano for me?
No, not at all. Can you hand me a bass guitar? Can you do that? You hand me an acoustic? I can do that a little bit, but no. No.
That's not his gift. We were joking about this earlier.
At all.
Now, tell me about your latest project.
My latest project is called Jesus Revealed. And what we're doing, quite honestly, and as simply as I can say it, is we are reintroducing the world to the biblical Jesus. That's really what we're doing. And
that's really what we're talking about.
Absolutely.
His presence in that word.
Absolutely.
Coming out into the form of songs. That's great.
And this record is very scripturally based, because most, if not all, of the songs are based off of some aspect of God or some aspect of Jesus who we're kind of unveiling through song. And the new single right now is a song called I Am that really encompasses the fullness of what we're, of what the record really talks about. And I Am is, for instance, if you were to have an opportunity to interview God, his response is, you say, well, just tell me a little bit about yourself. He would say, well, I'm a creator. I made the heavens and the earth. I'm a provider. I'm a strong tower. That's who I am. Absolutely. So he's, and God would say, well, that's who I am. And they say, well, you know, well, how would that apply to me? He would say, well, I'll tell you what, that's who I am. If you let me, I'll be that to you. And that's what the whole song is about.
I am excited
to hear this. Oh, yeah.
I really am. What are the creative ideas behind it?
Thank you.
Well, this is Jason Nelson. You'll get to see him this October on the next season of Dr. Bobby Jones Gospel. That's where I am here in Washington, D.C.